Hi, this is your host, Kristen Howe. I'm so excited to welcome you to our call with today's guest, Elisabeth Fayt. Elisabeth is a well-respected entrepreneur and founder of a successful Canadian chain of wellness spas. She has traveled the world working alongside global business leaders, has studied for over a decade with the masters in India, is a best-selling author, was a featured teacher in the Opus movie, and appears regularly on TV and radio. Elisabeth attributes her success to having a strong spiritual foundation. Her profound message bridges the gap between spirituality and business, illustrating how you can practice implementing spiritual principles in the material world. And this is so exciting. On today's call, we're going to talk literally about instant manifestation. And apparently, and this is really cool, so listen closely, Elisabeth is going to reveal to you the 10 qualities that you must have if you're going to be sort of a master manifester and a creator. And she'll talk to you about that in a minute. You'll also discover, you know, manifesting made practical. These are instant tips on how to make things happen, like we said, instantly. How to dig out the limiting beliefs that have been holding you back so you have no more limits. How to do the least to get the most by activating universal laws. The do's and don'ts of goal setting for successful manifestation that are simple and effective. You'll also discover powerful, proven secrets of being a powerful manifester, and you'll go through some exercises throughout the call to change your consciousness, create, and heal. So basically, everything we're talking about today is how to attract your ideal life now, and I love that. It's perfect. So Elisabeth, I'm so excited. Thank you so much for joining us today, and welcome to the call.
Oh, thank you, Kristen. I'm so eager to share the knowledge and wisdom and make a difference.
That's what I love. You know, just in talking with you, I'm like, oh, this woman, she is ready to go and bring everything she can to these people. So I'm psyched to have you here and be able to share you. Can you do me a favor? Could you share a couple of minutes of your story? You know, share maybe what you believe were some of the major turning points that have allowed you to manifest the current level of success that you have.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm going to be trickling those all throughout our hour together, Kristen, but really what brought me to the point where I had the awakening was in my 20s, I materially came to a point where I had everything I ever wanted, everything I desired. I had successful companies, homes. I was engaged to be married to a man that I loved. I had everything that you would want materially, but I found myself to be I felt unfulfilled. I felt empty. And one day, everything fell apart. Everything that I had known, everything that I had materially, I walked away from. I had an awakening and a realization that this is not for me. And I started from absolute scratch with leaving my relationship, leaving, walking away from my businesses, my companies with nothing. And I had nothing. And at that point is when I began my journey, and I found a book by Paramahansa Yogananda called Where There Is Light. And this book got me on my spiritual journey, where then I started to study with the masters and really embrace a spiritual life that I had no idea would change my life in the way it did. And that was the beginning of my journey, and everything else we're going to share in the next hour.
Fantastic. I can't wait. So your dime, your dance floor, I know that you maybe wanted to start off dealing with some of the limiting beliefs that everybody has. Is that still a great place to start?
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm going to start with a little story, just a short one that sort of describes the human tendencies and what gets us into the place that we are where we're stuck in manifesting. One of the saints that I studied with was Dayamata, who has just recently in the last few years passed on. But she was such a beautiful soul, and she was the head of Yogananda's organization. And she would just appreciate nature, and she would stand outside in her desert ashram. And one day she saw these beautiful hummingbirds, and she watched their behavior. And one day they started to all peck at the same piece of food. They started to argue and fight over the same little kernel of food. And she looked over to one of the monks and she said, "Look at those birds." She said, "They're just like humans. They don't know there is enough to go around for everyone."
Wow.
And that is the human psyche. That is the issue and the problem that most people have and what holds them back from manifesting is they feel that there is not enough to go around and they have to fight for it or they have to struggle for it. And life doesn't have to be a struggle. So I'd like to guide everyone through Kristen now. Just let's get into that place of feeling abundant. Let's get into that place of connecting to the source of abundance. So why don't we just take a few deep breaths and close our eyes and just connect and just feel the stillness for a moment. And as I say these words, feel that those words are yours and that they are true and that they are accessing the truth that is deep, deep within you. Everything I need comes to me easily. The universe is abundant, therefore I am abundant. Everything I need comes to me easily. The universe is abundant, therefore I am abundant. I attract true friends who are kind and respectful. I am worthy of a good relationship. I am worthy of true love. No matter what my role in life, I am worthy of success. Happiness is my divine birthright. I am worthy of happiness. Everything I need comes to me easily. The universe is abundant. Therefore, I am abundant. Just breathe, keep breathing, and feel that connection. And now this is an affirmation I want to guide you through that you're going to say out loud. When you're listening to this, I'm going to say it in sections and we're going to say it a few times. And if you get a chance, write this down. This affirmation is impregnated with huge, powerful manifestation vibrations. This affirmation will change your ability to manifest. It will open up the floodgates to receiving. And so here it is. So as I say the sections, you can repeat after me as you're listening to this. I go forth in perfect faith, in the power of omnipresent good, to bring me what I need at the time I need it. I go forth in perfect faith, in the power of omnipresent good, to bring me what I need at the time I need it. I go forth in perfect faith, in the power of omnipresent good, to bring me what I need at the time I need it. Now continue affirming that silently in your mind for just a few moments. Now, this affirmation is very powerful. So I ask you to write it down. Keep it close to you. Use it every day. Believe me, it will bring you the power of manifesting, the power of abundance, and it will connect you to the divine source. And this is what I want to share with you today, that if you want to be a powerful manifester, hang out with the most powerful manifester of all. It's who you know. It's who your friends are. If you want to look to someone, find out about them, look to their friends. So what I'm talking about is God, that divine source, that divine being, our creator that created us, that created everything. When we connect ourselves to the divine source, we have limitless power. I want you to think of yourself as having batteries that need to be recharged. Just like your iPod or your iPhone, you wouldn't think of not plugging it in because it would lose charge. But we ourselves, what happens to us when we lose our charge? That's when we start to struggle. That's when we start to feel the lack because we're not tapped in. We're not charged. We're not connected to the divine. And let me clarify this. We're always connected. So when I say connected, I mean aware of our connection. So it's when we are aware of our connection, that's when we receive and we are tapped in and we are able to receive an open floodgate to everything. Now, we live in a material world. So how do we manifest these material things? And the reason this up is that there are certain limits. Can we pray for a BMW and get it? Can we manifest that if that's what we want? Well, there are limits, and we want to overcome those limits. And we overcome the limits by learning about the universal laws. And so, Kristen, I need your help with this. I'm going to do a little exercise with everyone, but I'm going to start with you. You're
okay.
Up for this?
I am.
Okay. Often on stage, when I'm speaking in front of many people, I'll bring people up, and I'll play the Spice Girls song, Tell Me What You Want, What You Really, Really Want. So, and I get everyone to tell me what they really, really want. We have this little exercise. So, Kristen, if I could ask you, tell me what you want, what you really, really want. I'm going to put you on the spot here. What would you really, really want? Anything. Just tell me.
Like the biggest thing that comes to, I mean, the only thing that came to
anything.
Mind was to reach millions and help raise the vibration of the universe and be an enlightened multimillionaire.
Okay, wonderful, wonderful. All good desires, excellent. Now, if you had to summarize it into one word, what would that be? What do you want? What do you really, really want? What? Why do you want those things? What is it that you really want?
Why do you want
to reach millions? Why?
To fully connect.
You want to fully connect.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, what's holding you back?
Hmm.
Now remember, what I asked you is, what do you really, really want? Not something you have already.
Right.
Okay.
Time is the first thing that came to mind.
Okay. Perfect answer. Now, what I need you to do is embrace time. You have all the time in the world.
Hmm.
Time is your answer. Whatever you feel is holding you back, that is your stepping stone to how you need to get it. So this is great, and I'm going to show you how to manifest time. And I was going to do that later on, but we're going to do it right now. But I have a pre-pave that I say when we wake up in the morning, people are negatively thinking, oh, how am I going to get this done? I've got so much to do. That is common, so common. People, that's what they pre-pave. They set up their intention for not having enough time.
Hmm.
Most people can't fulfill their desires or reach their goals because they don't think they have enough time. This is a perfect example, Kristen. So instead, I say to people, wake up in the morning and say, I have all the time in the world. I have all the time in the world. Time is my friend. I have all the time in the world to do everything I need to do. And see, what happens is we set our intention in motion. Little things happen. I'll give you an example. Let's say we feel strapped for time and we wake up and we think, okay, well, I could do this, but I don't have enough time. You've lined it up that things are going to mess up your day so that you don't have enough time. Your child will pee his pants and you have to change him on the way out the door. Sorry for the bluntness, but
it happens,
right? Now, or someone will cut you off in traffic and you're stuck behind, or you're stuck in a traffic jam, or they don't have you're going to pick something up and they don't have it ready. You wasted time. You have to come back the next day. Do you think all of these things are coincidences, or have they happened because you've lined it up?
Because you lined it up.
So we create our time continuum. This is our creation. We can instantly manifest more time. Believe me on this, and trust me and try this. I have more time. I have more than enough time to do everything I need to do. And you will find that time will be your friend. You're going to have so much time. Everything you want to accomplish, you will have. I also have another way of increasing more time. How many times throughout the day are we asked, how are you? How are you? How are you? Oh, I'm fine. How are you? I'm fine. And it becomes an autopilot. We're not even thinking about our answer, or we're thinking, oh my gosh, I'm swamped. I have so much time, so busy. Well, that is the most common answer. People say, oh, so busy, I've got so much to do. That is a negative prepave that lines up. You're not going to reach your goals. You've got too much. You don't have enough time. So that is a manifest killer. So I have another response. When someone says, how are you? You say, I am blissfully productive. I'm blissfully productive. You have just intended happiness. You've just intended peace and calmness and productivity. Because you want both, right? You want
right.
that. And you want to be able to believe it. So if you're really running around with you, look like a chicken with your head cut off, for you to, you can't really believe it and say, oh, I'm blissful, I'm happy, I'm calm, I'm peaceful. Your subconscious mind would kick it out like, no, you're not, sister.
Right.
It would kick it out. It would not accept it. And you would actually be affirming the opposite. So we say, I am blissfully productive. And we put that out into the universe. You will watch things in my life. I'm a mother. I'm a business owner. I'm an international speaker. You can imagine the things that go on in a day. And people are amazed. They go, how do you get all this done? But I'll come downstairs and my nanny will have everything done for me that I hadn't even expected. I'll go to work and the report that I was to do, my spa director has done it for me. Oh, I had a few extra minutes. I did it for you. The universe is lining up everything so that everything falls into place. And so the goal here in this exercise is when I ask you, tell me what you want, what you really, really want, boil it down to what is it that you really, really want. Because we can say three sentences, four sentences, oh, I want this, I want that. But why? I did this on stage. A woman had said, oh, I'd like to get married. I'd like to, this is a goal she hadn't had. She hadn't found her soulmate. I'd like to get married. I'd like this, this, and this, and this. I said, but what is it that you want? And it took us 5 minutes to get down that I just want to be loved. That's all she wanted to be loved. I said, well, let's prepave that. Let's work on that. And because then when you say to the universe, I want love, universe, God, I want love. Well, I'll tell you, it will come. And it will come in ways that you hadn't expected, and it will come fast without limitations. And when we look and we say, well, what's holding you back? Most people, they say, me. I'm holding me back. I don't think I'm worthy. I'm bringing tears to my eyes because I'm feeling what these people are feeling. They don't feel worthy. And so one of the most common limiting beliefs we have is not feeling worthy. So that's why in our opening experiential, I said, I am worthy of a good relationship. I am worthy of true love. Do you know, I say that anytime I feel a little insecurity in my relationship, I have a wonderful husband who just treats me like gold. We have a beautiful relationship. I'm human. I have human feelings, and I'm constantly pivoting my feelings to the positive and my thoughts to the positive. So when I have a little insecure feeling, I think to myself immediately, I am worthy of a good relationship. I am worthy of true love. So I want, let's just each do this exercise. Close your eyes, and I ask you, tell me what you want, what you really, really want. Think in your mind, what is it? And now summarize it. Is that what you really want? Do you want that specific thing or that specific goal, or is it something far larger? Is it love that you want? Is it freedom? Is it abundance? Is it God? What is it that you want? Behind the barrier, behind the fluff, what is it? What is it? And now the big question, what's holding you back? Why are you asking for it? If you're asking for it, you don't feel like you have it yet. So why are you asking for this thing that you could already have? What's holding you back? If it's you, then love you, embrace you, be grateful, say, I am worthy. If you feel someone is holding you back, your husband's holding you back, your team is holding you back, whatever, embrace them. love them, be grateful for them. Whatever you feel is holding you back is actually the door that will open you to going and receiving and experiencing. So identifying what's holding you back, that's your door, that's your ticket, that's the secret. Embrace that, love that. And do this exercise as many times as you have to. Your desires will change over time. A month from now, we could ask you the same question, it's going to change. But the more you practice this, the more you get good at identifying that one word, what is it that I want? You can do this several times a day when you're having a challenging situation. Just say, well, what do I want here? What am I looking for? What do I really want? This is what I want from this. This is the outcome I want. Well, what's holding you back? And then when you see what's holding you back, you can pull it out. You can dig it out. You can throw it away and plant in there what you do want and water that seed daily and grow. Let it grow. This is a daily thing. You can do this 10 times a day. Very powerful.
Wow, now, I love that.
Oh, good. I hope it's powerful for everyone and they can use it. It's something I use all the time. It really works.
No, I'm sure everybody's going to get to start using that instantly because there's such a, there's like a relief to it.
Yes, there is. That is, whatever you want, it can be yours. You've got to just go do the work. You've got to do the process. Now, one thing I really love and just heard recently is I said, I am worthy, right? I am worthy of a true relationship. I am worthy of success. I am. We all know about the I ams, but I heard it recently said like this. What you say after I am comes looking for you. What you say after I am comes looking for you. So remember that. If that negative self-talk inside of you, you become aware of that. If that's saying, I am not good enough, or I'm not this, or I don't have enough time, or any, you know, I am time restrained, or whatever, it comes looking for you, and fast. Just as you can manifest instantly good things, you can also manifest negatively bad things. You are a powerful creator. The universe is waiting for your next command. What will it be? It will be your next thought, your next prepaid. So, Kristen, I'd love to go into the qualities of a master manifester.
Wonderful. I'm sure everybody is ready to write them down.
Mm-hmm. I've got about 10 here, but there's so many subcategories in them that there's so much information. So, yeah, get a pen. The first one is master manifestors are conscious intenders. And this is what I've been talking about, a technique I call pre-paving. What is a pre-pave? It's a sentence, a statement that tells the universe like it is. It tells it like it is. Like, I have all the time in the world. That's a pre-pave. You have set your intention, and the universe has taken that and said, okay, well, she's got all the time in the world, so we better give it to her. This is what she's intended. Pre-paving is a sentence. It can say, I have, I am, of course, is the most powerful one. But sometimes we say, I am, but we don't believe it. So what I mentioned before is that if we say, I am beautiful, even though we're not feeling very beautiful, our subconscious mind could kick it out and say, no, you're not. I mean, how many times have you said something like, oh, yeah, I'm smart. No, I'm not. And so we want to be careful of that. And the way to be careful of that, you can use pre-paving in stages. You can say, I want that. That's the first stage of pre-pave. I don't want you to stay in that area because we don't want to be in a state of wanting, and often teachers will say, never say I want, because that keeps you in a state of wanting. But I will say differently, that it is the first step. If you want to take yourself from a negative to a positive thought, if you're not feeling worthy, sometimes just saying I am worthy is not good enough because you'll kick it out. So you want to say, I want to be loved. I want to be loved. Well, that's believable, right? That's believable. You can say, God, I want to be loved. Send me love. I am starting to feel love. I know that with your help, God, I will feel loved. You see, so we start from, we take a negative and we pivot and we slowly bring ourselves to the positive by saying a prepay that says I want, I will, and then I have, or I am. Those are the highest. I want to show you an instant. Well, you may not call it instant prepay, but I'll show you how. It was
okay.
A very powerful prepay. Kristen, you had mentioned in my bio that I was for 10, well, I worked alongside global business leaders, but what you didn't mention is that for 10 years, I was private assistant, personal assistant, to a Canadian billionaire, Ron Joyce, the founder of Tim Hortons. I traveled around the world on his private jets and lived in his homes all around and managed his personal and professional affairs. And people would often look at me, Elisabeth, how could you get a job like this? I mean, it was amazing. I traveled the world. I met dignitaries, rock stars, movie stars, politicians. I mean, it was a phenomenal experience. And I was in my 30s at the time. And someone said to me, well, how did you get this job? And I remember that when I was 17 years old, I was studying secretarial school. I was pretty darn good secretary. And I had high hopes for myself. And I said to myself, I prepaved. One day, this is a prepaid, one day, I will be private assistant to a billionaire who has his own plane. And I pictured myself with a steno pad walking up the tarmac with him, briefcase in hand, helping him up the plane. And 20 years later, there I was. And I had forgotten that prepave until my sister had reminded me when I got the job offer. She said, Elisabeth, you prepaved this. Don't you remember? Now, instant manifestation, 20 years later, okay, that one prepave created my dream job. So we can do that with one prepave. I prepaved my husband. If you want to manifest a soulmate, I really, really wanted a soulmate, and I knew the way to do it, but I want to tell a story. I was living with a girl, my roommate at the time, and she was looking for her soulmate, and she was really big on lists, and often, law of attraction coaches will say, oh, make a list, and put all those things down there that you want, and it's fantastic. Anything you do to help create and manifest is fantastic. You're going in the right direction. But this woman put everything on this list, and I said, well, have you covered everything? Make sure you get everything on there. And she said, oh, yes. And so she would keep adding things because she would meet people. And she'd go, oh, you know. Anyway, she finally came up with the perfect list and came to me. And she says, I have found the guy for me, and he's perfect and everything. And after about 3 or 4 months, she came to me so sadly, and she goes, oh, there was one thing I forgot, just one little thing, but it was really, really big. And so here she was. She had everything on the list. She was a powerful creator, but she had forgotten something. So our manifestation can have flaws in it. Mm. When we do that, when we limit ourselves by giving a list, giving God a list, I want these 5 things. Well, God was willing to give you 10 things. So why are you limiting yourself? I say, You want to prepave your soulmate? I prepaved love. I said, God, I want love. I want to be so in love, and I want him to be so in love with me that I feel love all the time. And so that takes care of the future, too. That takes care of when I'm in my relationship, and I have a most amazing relationship that I prepaved that way, and you can do it, too. And I had no limits. I wanted to feel love all the time, so God brought me someone who was going to sustain that for me. Mm. I didn't have to ask, make him be kind. I want him to look this way. I want him to make this kind of money, right? I prepaid love, and so we do the same. That when we, the do's and don'ts of goal setting, people, you know, set a goal, that's great. Set it by a date if you want. I say no, though. I mean, if you want to do that, it's fine, but if you want to listen, you want to be a master manifester, you want abundance? Prepave abundance. Feel it. Go out. Do what it takes to feel abundant. If you really have no money in the bank, then think of the 5 things that make you feel abundant. Like, well, I have an abundance of food in my fridge right now. I have an abundance of friends. I have an abundance of love. I have an abundance of anything. And that will attract the financial abundance. But here's what happens, you see, because how we think, how we feel resonates around us. Every thought you think lodges in your energy field around you. And that energy, we're going to talk a little more about that. That energy field is your magnet that attracts. So how you feel is what attracts. So if you say, I'm going to be a millionaire by age 30. Okay, well, you're 29. And it's not happening yet. And what happens to the vibration? What happens to that energy field around you? What happens? You start to doubt. You start to get a little worried. Okay, well, I've got time. I'm going to do it. You start to become tense. That tension is so powerful. That tension is instantly manifesting a vibration that is of like kind. So then you start to little things, little signs start to come that you're not going to make it for 30. You're not going to make that goal at the time that you thought. And little things, little indications come in, it's not going to happen, and you can become even more tense. And you create more tension into your vibration. And that affects everything. And then you wonder why the whole thing flops. So I say prepay of abundance. Say, God, I'm going to put it in your hands. I surrender. I want abundance. You know what kind of abundance I want. You know better than me. I always, whenever I'm negotiating with someone, I always say, surprise me. And you know, a great prepay, because you're going to get far more. And I say that to God, because you're going to get far more than when you say, God, this is what I want. And you know, I know teachers say, be clear. I say, be clear on how you want to feel. God, I want to feel loved. I want to feel abundant. This is how I want to feel. I know you know how to give this to me. And by the way, God, I love you. I want you above all. But this is how I want to feel, and I know you want me to be happy. So help me. Give me what I need, what you think I need. And when we open that up, God will always surprise you. I have a great prepay for that. And miracles. We want miracles. But miracles happen when we look for them. Half the time we're asleep at the switch. We wake up and we're grumbling about something, or maybe we do start with gratitude. But let me give you a prepave that will just knock the socks off your day. You will see miracles, more than one, often. And this is it. Something wonderful is going to happen today. Something wonderful is going to happen today. Each one of you, I want you to say it out loud. If you're at home or in the car, say it. Something wonderful is going to happen today. Make that your first thought. Watch your life change. Watch your ability to manifest change. You just instantly manifested miracles. Your day will be full of miracles. I remembered one day I'd forgotten to prepave it, and it was 9:00 at night. And I thought about it, and I said, oh, there's still time. It's only 9:00 at night. I said, something wonderful is going to happen today. And you know, something did. I connected with my stepdaughter that evening in a way I had not in a very long time. And I just smiled at God and I said, thank you, God. You always come through. You always come through. Something wonderful is going to happen today. Miracles happen when you're looking for them. You intend miracles, they will happen. Instant manifestation, I'll tell you a miracle. It was my son's 6th birthday last summer. And we have a vacation home in the mountains, and we spent most of the summer there. And I realized at 6, he had never seen a rainbow. And he said, Mom, what does a rainbow look like? And I said, what? You haven't seen a rainbow? I mean, I'm almost 50 years old. I've seen many rainbows, and it's kind of one of those things we almost take for granted. Imagine taking a rainbow for granted, colors in the sky by God, saying, hello, I'm here. And so many times we take it for granted. And I said, you know what, Adrian? Why don't we prepave it? It's your birthday. Maybe God will give it to you for your birthday. And honest to God, I swear to my creator, we were having supper, and all of a sudden it started to rain. And it was like a drizzle, and it hadn't rained all summer. The drizzle went away, and we said, oh, my goodness, let's go to the window. We went out there. There was the biggest rainbow, biggest, fattest, brightest rainbow I've ever seen in my life. You have no idea the feeling we had, that feeling that of instant manifestation. You can do this. You can do this. And it's not being cocky with God's world and God's laws and saying, ha ha, I can do this, or God, show me this, or testing him. No, we weren't testing God. We were loving God and asking for a miracle, and we got it. It was the most amazing moment in my life of manifestation.
Wow. Yeah, I can only imagine.
Yeah, each one of you can do this. So, powerful manifestors are conscious intenders. Another one, they are serviceful. They focus on service. I have a really powerful story I want to share. Ron Joyce, the billionaire, he hired me for one reason. I'd been working in his office for a while, and as a secretary. And it was then he saw how I worked, and it was then that he said, "Listen, my assets are becoming liquid. I'm going to go travel and build things all over the world. I need someone to do it with me, and I need that person to be you." And he said to me, he said, "Elisabeth, you make things happen. So I need you with me." And really what he was saying is, "You're a powerful creator. You're a powerful manifester. I need you with me. I need you make things happen." And that's what it is. Anyone can be this way. Anyone can make things happen. And I can tell you so many examples. But this is the most powerful turning point, I would believe, in my life when it came to becoming a really good manifester. And he had said to me, he said, I mean, he had never had anyone in this position before, so he didn't know what I would do. I was going to travel with them. I was going to take care of every little last detail of his life. He said, but I really don't know if I'm, you know, how to keep you busy. I ended up working 7 days a week, you know, 24/7. But he said, here, I'm going to give you a job description that's a one-line job description. He said, just add value to my life. Add value to my life. Now, this just, wow. I had a one-line job description to add value to his life. I prepaid that. I would write it in my journal. I add value to Mr. Joyce's life today. And I'll tell you, that gave me purpose. That is your purpose, adding value, being serviceful. I was able to make things happen in his life. I had him in tears so many times, tears of joy, tears of awe. Here's a billionaire. How do you please a billionaire? He can buy anything he wants. And I'll tell you, I had him in tears watching and viewing the manifestation right before his eyes, things that really meant something to him, because all I did was focus on adding value. That is your purpose. Everyone who's listening, that is your purpose. So I say to you, this is not my job description. This is your job description. You have the same one-line job description. God says to you, add value to my world. Add value to my world. That's it. Add value to my world. Now, what would happen in your relationships if you took the focus off what is he thinking? How am I feeling? What am I getting? You know, what am I getting out of this? Maybe we don't come out and say it, but really that's what we're thinking. How am I being treated? How do I feel? Am I being respected? All these things. Well, sure, they're natural. It's part of the natural psyche, human psyche, like the hummingbirds. But it's not going to bring you abundance. What's going to bring you abundance is what's going to bring you to a point of being a conscious intender, a conscious manifester, is by adding value. If you said in your relationship, if you focused on how can I add value to my relationship, I'll tell you what, you will instantly manifest love. You will instantly manifest value. You will become valuable. When we add value, what happens? We become valuable. When we stand at the water cooler and talk about how we're undervalued and underpaid, we are that. We are a match for that. So bring it on. It's going to come on in droves, because that is exactly what we're asking the universe for. At work, I want you to change your work environment by focusing on adding value. You can prepave. Today I add value. That's what I did. I add value to Mr. Joyce's life today. I add value to my family today. How can I add value? Believe me, when you focus on that, you will be a person who makes things happen. Mr. Joyce put that on the back cover of my book. Elisabeth Fayt is a powerful, powerful woman. She makes things happen. Makes things happen. You are the same as me. You have the same ability and the same qualities within you. All you have to do is practice them. Change that shift. It's a paradigm shift. Change from what do I get? What am I experiencing? How am I feeling? It's good to be in tune with that. Don't lose that. That's intuition. Be in tune with how you feel. But your primary focus should be, how can I serve? Master manifestors serve. They are serviceful. Next one. They give unconditional effort. Do you know how many times or how difficult it is working for a billionaire? Things didn't always come. The results didn't always come, so I had to give unconditional effort. I'll give you an example when I built my own business. I had a dream to build many, after I left Mr. Joyce, after 10 years, I had a dream to build many wellness spas. And so I had an idea, if I put a little mini wellness spa in every corporation, wouldn't that be awesome? All the employees could come for massage and benefits, health, wellness. It'd be beautiful. Well, I was turned down at every corner. And people were saying to me, give it up, Elisabeth. What are you doing? You know, you're wasting your time. And I know the power of unconditional effort. I know that no matter what happens as a result, when I put in effort, I will get a result. And so finally I got my first contract, and it was a company that had offices across Canada. So this was my ticket. This was my big win, my big cash in. And we were all ready to go. I'd hired the team. I had gotten the equipment, and we were all set up. At the 11th hour, the director of the company came in and gave me the bad news. What he thought, what everyone would have thought, the bad news. Elisabeth, it's not going to happen. I know you've worked for this. I love your concept. I love you. I think you are going to make it, but this is not going to work. Now, you can imagine all that effort. How would people feel? How do you feel when your effort isn't rewarded instantly? You know, often we feel crushed. We feel downtrodden. We start to create negativity. Okay? You're a powerful creator. You're creating in the moment. What are you creating at any moment? You've got to be very aware of that. And so I knew that. I knew the power of effort. So I remained happy. I was happy. I was so happy. So I said, it's okay. I love the process I learned from. I know something good will come of this. I'm so happy that I had the chance, and I know that whatever is coming around is right around the corner. My team didn't feel the same way. It was a hard sell. I will tell you that, because they didn't have that same consciousness as I had. They didn't have that same understanding. I was trying to show them. And I can sell ice to Eskimos, but this was a tough sell for them to believe in me that, listen, it's around the corner. 2 weeks later, I got a call from the director who had turned me down, and he said, Elisabeth, I'd like to have lunch with you. So we sat down, and he said, I couldn't give you the contract, he said, but I know two people who could. And he handed me two business cards. And I'll tell you the glory and the blessedness in this. They were two business cards of general managers of major five-star hotels in Calgary. So, and today I have 16 mini wellness centers in hotels. So what I had been focusing on was corporations, when really the universe was trying to shift my direction to, no, go into hotels. Hmm. So all of my effort, and every month I prepaved, I would open another site, and I did. How do you do that? How do you open in one site a month? I mean, that's, people would say, how would anyone have enough time? I have all the time in the world, and the universe supports me. The universe is abundant. I am worthy of success. I prepaved it. I made it happen. And you can do the same. You have to set your intention on what is it that you really, really want and embrace those things that you think are holding you back. So, qualities of a powerful manifester: conscious and tender, serviceful, unconditional effort. Do you see that these are things that are totally doable. The next one is happy. Be happy. You know, my spa today it's a really successful business, and I love it. Last year, I was doing a big speech with Deepak Chopra for 2,000 people, probably my largest, 2,500 actually, my largest crowd. And 2 days prior to that, I'm outside the front, and our laundry machines had broken down, and I'm loading up loads of laundry into my SUV. And one of the organizers of the Chopra event was walking up, and they said, Elisabeth, in two days, you're speaking on stage with Deepak Chopra. And I said, yeah, I know, and today I'm hauling laundry. Isn't it beautiful? Isn't it absolutely beautiful? And I meant it. I meant it. Service, happiness, unconditional happiness. Whatever, you know, your life, it's called dharma. And my guru, Paramahansa Yogananda, says, those duties that come to man or woman in the natural course of their life are those they are meant to perform. So if laundry is something I'm meant to perform because the washer went down, then I will perform it, and I will perform it with happiness and with enthusiasm and with willingness. And if speaking on stage in front of 2,000 people, if that's where God wants me, I'll do that too. And I'll do it with every ounce of me. I'll put my whole heart in it, and I will do my very best. It doesn't matter if you ask me to scrub the floor or ask me to talk on a radio show in front of thousands of people. I'll put the same effort in. Because how we do one thing is how we do everything. Mm. The universe is watching, always watching. You are never alone. Universe, will bring you the ability to manifest. And that's why we're here. We came to learn how to be master manifestors. That's our purpose, too, giving service and learning how to use God's laws. He wants us to use them. He's handed us this book of the universe, and all we have to do is open it and start to use these laws. So how do we... Unconditional effort means happiness all the time. It means giving up moods. Are you willing to give up moods? Are you willing to give up moods? If you want to be happy all the time, you say, well, yeah, I want happiness, and I want to manifest. I want these good things. But darn it, this person over here, she really ticked me off, and so I'm not speaking to her right now. Well, you know, you think there's no correlation, and you think there's no connection, but think again. Huge connection. Master manifestors are happy beyond condition, regardless of effort they've put in. They are happy without condition. They are happy without expectation. They are not. They do not indulge or engage in moods, because moods are manifestation killers. Now the next one, eyebrows are gonna raise, because you're gonna think it's gonna contradict what we've been talking about. But I want to go really deep here, deep spiritually. No desires. Powerful manifestors have no desires. Mm. I want you to think about this. Do you know that having no desires brings peace? And when you have peace of mind, God gives you everything you need, everything you want. You're abundant. You're like overwhelmed. I feel so overwhelmed with the blessings in my life. I have no desire. There's nothing. If you ask me, what do you want? What do you really, really want? Nothing. I have everything. I have it. I can't even say what I want or what I have, because the list is too long, and I can't even, there are not words to express it. When we have a desire, there's tension with that. Even Kristen, let's take a look at your desire. I want to be a millionaire by whatever age or whatever. There's an expectation of that. There's a tension with that. Really, everyone, I want you to listen to this. No desires. I heard it just recently. Oprah was talking about, there was something she really, really, really wanted to be in the color purple, really wanted. And she ended up doing it. She pre-paved and intended her way in, and she tells her story, and it's just an amazing story. But she said to herself, never again do I want to want something that badly.
Mm.
She said, now whatever it is, if it comes, I allow it to come through me. And if it goes, I allow it to go. And if it's going to come through me, it's going to come. And I want it to come freely and effortlessly, and that's what God wants. He wants us to manifest effortlessly. But if you ever feel that you have desires, there's an instant attachment. Is that desire going to come? And here's the thing. What Yogananda says is that wrath is born of thwarted desire. Okay, so let me explain this. Wrath meaning moods. Like, why are you in a mood? It's because a desire of yours has not been fulfilled. Anytime you're in a mood, you can look and say, okay, I ask myself, what desire has not been fulfilled that has thrown me into this? You can always pin it down to a desire. And when you pluck out that desire and say, okay, I let that go, I release that, you open yourself up. You see, what are you willing to do to become a master manifester? Yeah, I want to make things happen. I want to create. I want to be a major creator. I want to do this, this, and this. But am I willing to give up moods? Am I willing to give up resentment? Am I willing to give up negative thinking? Am I willing to release some of these things I'm hanging on to that's stopping me? Am I willing to take off the brakes? These are the things you have to ask yourself. There's a brother, a monk in the ashram who is no longer alive. He passed several years ago, Brother Primamoy, beautiful, saintly man. And he would say to the devotees, the young monks, as they were coming in as postulants into the ashram, just brand new, he would say to them, there are a lot of things you're going to be asked to do. There are a lot of things you're going to be asked to give up. Are you willing to do what it takes to find God, to find, or I'll say in lay terms, to find freedom? Are you willing to do it? And all of the monks, they're all coming in eager and enthusiastic, as we all would when we want it. Yes, I want to be a manifester. I'm willing to do it. I am willing. Count me in. Sign me up. I'm good. But then what Brother Primamoy would find is that down, as he's starting to coach these young monks, and as he would guide them, he would say, okay, you're going to have to give up that behavior. You're going to have to give up that thought. And the monk would say, oh, well, anything, but not that one. I'm really kind of, you know, attached to that chip on my shoulder. I'm attached to that chip. This one, anything else, brother, I'll give up anything, but not that. And I'm sharing this because this is everybody. You want to be a powerful creator? Are you willing to give up the things you need to give up? Are you willing to think the thoughts, think in the way? Are you willing to expand your consciousness? Are you willing to do that? We may be enthusiastic and all gung-ho, but when push comes to shove and it's really time to give it up or to do it, are you willing? Are you going to do it? That's what separates the mediocre manifestors to the master manifestors. So who are we? Who are you? Where do you fit? So qualities of a powerful manifester: conscious intention, serviceful, unconditional effort and happiness beyond condition, no desires. Okay, the next one is, this is really powerful, humility and modesty. If you've got an ego, if your ego, I mean, we all have egos. We have an ego. Even Jesus had an ego. In order to be in a physical body, we have that persona, okay? But it's attachment to the ego and who's running the show. Who's running this bodily form? Who's running your human form? Is it your ego or is it your soul? Master manifestors are guided by their soul. Their ego's in the background. And these are one of those things that are the hard things to give up. And it comes in different disguises. Ego comes in disguise of a mood. It comes in disguise of resentment. It comes in disguise of doubt. It comes in lots of disguises. You don't see it, but it's just the ego. It comes in disguise of hurt feelings, you know. So humility is not being the least. It's not saying, oh, I'm little, I'm the least. And no, it's humility is quietness of heart. Quietness of heart. We see the miracles. When we have a quiet heart, we see what's around us. And then we are able to manifest. And we'll be able to manifest the right things. You already are a powerful manifester. You're manifesting good and bad. So you are instantly manifesting, whether you get a parking stall or whether you get no parking, you've manifested that. And you've manifested that instantly. So you're already doing it. So let's get rid of the ego. Let's practice humility, quietness of heart. And then we become manifestors of good, manifestors of abundance, manifestors of love. And how, again, quietness of heart, what does that mean? It means never to be perplexed, never to be fretted, never to be upset, never to be sore about something like, oh, that person hurt me. Well, those are the things that, yeah, you know what, maybe it's going to hurt. There's a prayer that we say in the ashram, oh, Lord, chisel thou my life according to thy design. Chisel thou my life according to thy design. The monks lead us in that. And some people say, oh, that's a brave prayer. Chisel thou my life. Because what happens is God will chisel. And believe me, he will. He will chop off those things that are standing in your way. But when you get a big chunk come off, you go, ouch, that hurts. That hurts my ego. And so you pick up that chunk and you slap it back on again. And you glue it in or you weld it in and okay, whew, that feels better now. But you're not going on the road of powerful, positive manifesting. So if you want a powerful prayer, let's say it now, just inwardly. Chisel thou my life according to thy design. Chisel thou my life according to thy design. Chisel thou my life according to thy design. And then be ready. Be ready for the chiseling. But where is the sculptor when he is doing the sculpture? Where is he? Is he far away? Is he up in the skies? Is he up in heaven? Or he is right by the piece. So when God, the universe, when the creator is sculpting you and chiseling you, he is right there. He is right there. So you have all the help in the world. You know, the monks say there are two kinds of meditators. And this is important because we want to connect to source in order to be powerful manifestors, because the source is, it's just as I began in the beginning. You want to be like the source, hang out with the source, connect with the source. And there are two kinds of meditators. First kind, those who connect with God. And the second kind, those who don't. So I'd say if I have a chance to connect to God by him chiseling off all the things that are standing in my way, I'll take it. because it means he's going to be close to me. And even though maybe it might hurt, but in the end, we're going to have an amazing sculpture. And that sculpture is going to be worth it. Yeah. And I'm worth it. So all those things are motivators, you know, inspiration to do it. That the goal, yeah, you know what? When people would come in to Master Yogananda's training, like I've gone into, like I am in his training, he would say goodbye to your old life. The training may be severe, but you will not recognize your life. As we go through this, you will not recognize your life. So the next quality is fearlessness. And we easily transition into this quality because what fearlessness is, it's not being not afraid of something. Oh, well, I'm not afraid of nothing. You know, it doesn't mean like you can go in heights, I can go in closets. I'm not afraid of tigers. It's not that. Fearlessness, what it means spiritually, is an unequivocal faith that God is with whom you have to do, that God is in charge, that he is sustaining you like the hummingbirds. If you feel like the hummingbird that you have to struggle and you have to fight for your bit, then you do not have unequivocal faith in God that he will sustain you. You are in resistance, not surrender. There's two states of mind, resistance or surrender. When you are in surrender, it's like just like the two meditators. There's the meditators who connect with God and the meditators who don't. Fearlessness is unequivocal faith in God. The next one is to give with gratitude. Powerful manifestors give with gratitude. If you give and you think, okay, well, I'm giving, and so then that person owes me, it's kind of like, well, I helped you move. So, you know, kind of almost expecting a gift. When we give, we need to give with gratitude. Like, and I mean gratitude. Don't give, is our giving a gift and thinking, well, they'll probably give me something, or, gee, I gave them something, and every year I give them something, and they never give me something. Nonsense. You can have that feeling, and you're like the hummingbird. That's the human psyche. Well, you're not human. You are divine. And if you want to experience and express those divine qualities, and you want to be a powerful manifester, you're going to have to drop those human qualities, and you're going to have to adopt some of these divine ones. So when you give with gratitude. Powerful manifestors have right attitude in everything. This is huge, really, really huge. How do we deal with our challenges? I'm going to give you one quick tool on how to have right attitude. I have many of them. One quick tool is usually when we have challenges, it's because of people. Someone's behaved a certain way, and you just can't believe it, and you can't get over it, and how could they do that? And they've ruined this and ruined that. And, you know, the outdoor blame, which really is that big chip that needs to come off your hip, okay? That has to come off of you in order for you to grow and create. So whenever you're in a challenge, ask yourself this. Putting aside everything else, the things you don't have control over, that person, that thing, you don't have control over them. You have control over you. So ask yourself this. How ought I behave? How ought I behave? Then, when you answer that question, then what you do is you 100% follow it. And you focus on that. Remember service, adding value. How can I add value to this situation? That is how you get yourself with right attitude out of challenges. The next quality of a master manifestor is they do the work. And we've already talked about this, so we'll just summarize. They do the work. Like when the monk says, are you willing to give up what you need to give up? Are you willing to do what you need to do in order for freedom? Well, manifesting is freedom. To be able to manifest at will what you need, what you want, that's freedom. Are you willing to do the work, though? You know, that's the thing. So are you willing to lose the guilt? Because guilt is just that big chip. Are you willing to lose the resentment? Are you willing to lose the doubt? Are you willing to be fearless? Are you willing to give with gratitude? Are you willing to have the right attitude? So those are the things. The very last quality is mindfulness. I saved it for last because you can have all of the other ones. If you are not mindful, you miss the point. You miss the point. A master manifester is mindful. Every moment of the day is a moment to create. If you're only mindful for a few moments in the day, you are manifesting for a few moments in the day. Consciously manifesting, let's say. Consciously manifesting good. Remember, You are an instant manifester all the time. Your vibration is manifesting all of the time, constantly. And what you are manifesting, you are getting. So that's a given. But what we're here to do is to learn how to be a master manifester of the good, of good, of what it is that we need, so we're always sustained. So in order to do that, you must be mindful. And I'm going to leave, you know, sort of end with a couple of quotes on being mindful. Thich Nhat Hanh says, when we live with a child or with a spouse, a friend, their freshness and warmth can relax us. But if our heart is not with them, their precious presence is neglected and they no longer exist. We must be aware of them to appreciate their value, to allow them to be our happiness. Now, when we're with someone and our mind is not present with them, we are not aware of them. We are not in the moment. We're not available to them. And they are not available to us. And if you want to be a master at creating love, you want to create a healthy relationship, you have to be mindful in it. You want to create abundance, you've got to be mindful. You have to be mindful in every moment. Every moment is an opportunity to create. You are an instant manifestation creator. You are an instant manifester. So I will leave you with, what is it that you want to manifest? You want to manifest good? Do you want to manifest consciously? Remember, miracles happen when we look for them. Miracles happen when we are present. Why don't you create a rainbow? Why don't you start every day with something wonderful is going to happen today? And I'll give you another example, just a quick example to end. Instant manifestation. What happens when you give a hug? You are hugged at the same time, aren't you? Hmm. When you give a hug, you are hugged. You give a hug, you give love, you receive instantly. And here's a quote I just heard from Oprah. Whatever you do is already done to you. Whatever you do is already done to you. Instant. Instant manifesting.
Wow. I love that. This whole thing, you've given us so much, but what I love about it is it's not overwhelming. It's just, I don't know, it already feels like you can easily integrate it into yourself, you know, and that's, I love how you've delivered all of this, because you tell us what it is, but then you give us an example, so it's really allowed it to sort of already sink in, and that's huge, because we're going to leave the call with it already sinking in and already resonating. So thank you, just amazing.
Oh, I'm glad.
Yeah, your energy is fantastic. Do you have, you know, I know that you said there was a success story that you wanted to share with us, and I would love, because I know everybody loves hearing, you know, sort of what's possible for them. So could you share that with us now?
Mm-hmm. Well, I have a program in which you're going to offer today to people. And I had a lady who started on my program a couple of years ago. And when she started, she was like every other student I've had. Same issues, relationship issues, lack of abundance, all those things, negative thoughts, string of negative prepays, just the way the normal person, 99% of people live in this day. And after a year of listening to my downloads and working with me, honestly, she is, as I said earlier, with when Yogananda counsels someone and says, be ready to say goodbye to your old life. You will not recognize your life. She cannot recognize her life. I cannot recognize her life. She is a different person. Now on our mentorship calls, she does the teaching. She has become the teacher. She has become the inspiration. She comes not to ask questions. She comes to add value. She is absolutely 100% turnaround. She's amazing. She listened to what I had to say, and she applied it. And that's the difference. When someone listens and applies it, they get the gold. They get the jackpot.
Hmm.
I'm so proud of her, and she knows it. And she's proud of herself. She's made huge changes. And that has ripple affected to hundreds of people. Everyone she touches has ripple affected to it. So, and that's the power we have. We affect our own vibration. Is, you know, you want to change the world, change yourself.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
I love that. What a great example. I think that's so, it's so powerful, and I love that you talked about the ripple effect, because that's one of the things I'm so passionate about, you know, and that's one of the reasons I get so excited about being able to bring people like you and share them with it, this amazing group of people that, that gets on and listens to these calls, is because I know that the ripple effect, you know, is going to raise the vibration of the world, and that's just fantastic. I get so excited about that. And I know there's, I mean, obviously you gave us so much today, but there's so much more to learn from you and to work with that you have. And I know you created a special offer for everybody listening. So what I want to do is I'm going to give everyone the link, and everyone, I highly encourage you, go to Elisabeth's special offer right now so that you can experience this for yourself as she talks you through it.
To access this page for yourself, simply click on the special offer button that's on this page.
And Elisabeth, it would be great if you could sort of walk us through what you have there.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's 12 hours of talks. And so if you enjoyed this talk and got a lot out of it, these 12 hours are just as powerful. And each hour talk has a specific topic. So we dive really, really deep. One would be just on the law of attraction, just on how to access that universal law to open the floodgates to abundance. Another one is the law of deliberate creation. We work for an entire hour on just pulling out those weeds of limiting beliefs. We touched on it briefly today, but I dive really deep, and we do exercises and pivoting exercises on getting rid of those limiting beliefs so that you can then plant the positive seeds. One of the hours is just on how to spiritualize your life. And powerful tools, practical tools. I'm all about practicality. You can be inspired by something, but if you can't make it practical in your life, then it's not worth anything. It will just fluff over you. So I'm all about practical. So I give lots of practical examples, practical tools, exercises, things you can do. And I find that my students listen to these over and over and over again. There's just so much packed with information. And one of them is just on how to get the most out of meditation, how to really deepen your meditations. So if you're interested in connecting to the source, there's a great hour on that. There's one on how to manifest your goals, the do's and don'ts of, I shared a few today, but I have a whole hour on just, actually two sessions on the do's and don'ts of goal setting, the little things you do that are holding you back and how to pull those out, how to stop it. Simple shift. And the thing is I know I've been there, I've been the student, I'm still the student. I know that a small shift is huge. It can make huge changes, not in a year from now, instantly, instant changes in your job, in your marriage, in your family life, everything. I know the power of these 12 hours. That you don't want to miss it. It will change your life. It'll be worth it.
I can hear how it'd be worth it. And what I love is that what you're saying, it sounds like no matter, okay, so whatever we're going through, there's going to be a recording that we can then go, ooh, I'm going to listen to this one. I'm going to use this one right now. And I think that's so powerful. What a tool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they are really, really powerful. I highly recommend them.
Now, let me ask you this. What, when people start actually using these, and obviously, you know, I'm sure the long-term benefits are immense, but what are some of the short-term sort of immediate things that they could expect to start to experience in their lives that would be a shift?
Well, immediate happiness. And I will guarantee you that. I will guarantee you, because the moment you reach for the higher thought, you've changed your vibration. This is what the whole, all of the exercises really in all the different facets of life are teaching you. What I teach is to reach for the higher thought. And because we're sitting down here in a realm of thoughts, wherever we are, our consciousness is at a certain level, and these are the thoughts we have to choose from. This is the happiness level we have to choose from. That's why they've talked about happiness levels and happiness bars, and you can't, even someone who wins the lottery will get right back down to their level of happiness. Why is that? Because this is the realm of thoughts they have access to. So when you access some of the things that I teach you how to reach for the higher thought, which brings you up. Just picture yourself raising a bar, bringing yourself up to a whole new realm of thoughts, to a whole new realm of opportunities, a whole new realm of miracles. It's like if you're in your little world and you're in a house and you're in lots of rooms and you can only see the room you're in. But if you raise yourself up above and you see the whole floor plan, you can, I see that room. Oh, my goodness, my consciousness has expanded. I see it all, because you've raised your vibration. And this is what it does. It instantly raises your vibration, and you see things from a different, oh, my goodness, it's an awareness. And everything is different. everything, every little technique and tool that I teach in these classes, it will raise your vibration to a point where you go, wow, I had no idea. I wish I'd done this 20 years ago. That's what people tell me. Where were you 20 years ago?
That's so great. And I love, I mean, just even saying, you know, immediate happiness, because really, I mean, you know, that's really what it's all about. So I love that. And I personally, I am a believer that when you raise your vibration, when you reach that, you know, that state of happiness, you can manifest anything from those states of being. So I love that that's, you know, you're giving us access to those incredible creative states. And I appreciate that. Again,
if you haven't yet, just click on the special offer button on this page to see for yourself what an amazing package this is. You'll be glad you did.
Elisabeth, you've been fantastic. I mean, there's not even a word to describe what you've been, but I'm going to use fantastic. You've given us so much, and I'm so excited that I was able to share this call with our listeners today, because I know that there is just so much that they've gotten out of it. Do you have, and I even kept you a little long, and I so appreciate you hanging in with me here. Do you have any sort of final words that you want to send us off with?
Okay. I don't have time to tell the whole story, a really powerful story of what my father taught me before he passed away, but I will share sort of the moral. As we all know, when we lose someone, we wish we had more time with them. We wish we had been more present with them. And I think if I could leave you with anything, it's to remind you that the most important person is the one who is in front of you. And the most important task is the one that you are doing. Mm. And when you remember that, it will keep you present. And you will be able to create amazing things. It will change your life immensely. The most important person, whoever that is a store clerk, it doesn't really matter, but get off your BlackBerry. Someone's in front of you and they need you. They need you to be present. And if you are not present, you are not available to them and they are not available to you. And you miss the miracle. The most important person is the one in front of you. And the most important task is the one that you are doing. Remember that always.
Wow. Perfect words to end with. Elisabeth, thank you so much. I can't wait till we get to do this again. And I'm really excited for everyone and everybody here listening. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You're all absolutely magnificent. And until the next time, keep manifesting. Bye-bye, everyone. Oh.
Thank you.